evening. Before we begin, I just want to point out a few things. If you have not picked up a program in the front of the church, in front of the ambo, please do so at this time. And thank you for staying closer to the front of the church where you'll be able to sing together more readily. Also, we will take a second just to look at the refrain portion of the opening hymn. And the Schola will also help with this. And all throughout the Vespers, obviously you will sing on the alls, and I will also sing with you, but you will also sing choir two. The Schola will do choir one, and we ask you to do choir two. I'm going to ask the Schola to sing the refrain, O Maker God. If you notice in the middle of the opening hymn, that it has that refrain right there. I'm going to ask them to sing right on it.
Thank you. Temple in Jerusalem, and perfect your work in us. Alleluia. A reading from the letter to the Ephesians. Make every effort to preserve the unity which has the Spirit as its origin and peace as its binding force. There is but one body and one Spirit, just as there is but one given all of you by your call. There is one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is over all and works through all and is in all. The word of the Lord. Today we celebrate the great feast of Pentecost, the birth of the church. In our scriptures, even at this the reading that we just heard, as well as the scriptures for the Mass, it recalls that great event where the Holy Spirit came down upon the 12, the apostles, and helped them, made them strong enough to witness to their faith. This morning, I had the privilege of celebrating the Feast of Pentecost at St. Philip's in Lyonsville, where I also confirmed some of the parishioners. I think it's probably one of the best times to celebrate the sacrament of confirmation, because in many ways we're reliving that great event that took place on the first Pentecost, when the Holy Spirit came down upon the apostles and enabled them through the gifts that the Holy Spirit gave them to witness to their faith. As we know from the scriptures, the apostles were locked in that room in Jerusalem because they were afraid. They were afraid for themselves what would happen. Jesus had ascended. They felt alone. They felt unable to do anything. In a sense, fear paralyzed them. And yet the Holy Spirit came, and just with those few apostles, they had the courage, because of the gifts of the Holy Spirit, to go forward and proclaim the good news of Jesus Christ. And I think what is remarkable and goes to show you the power of the Holy Spirit, there were just a handful of apostles. Look where we are today as the church. It's so different. If those apostles would have stayed locked up in that room in Jerusalem, would we be here today? But they had the courage to go forth. And this was a point I tried to make to these students and to the people in Lyonsville, that the same Spirit that came upon the apostles came upon us. We have that same Spirit. We receive the same gifts. But like the apostles, sometimes fear overtakes us, and it paralyzes us from going forth and witnessing to our faith. We're afraid. What will people say? What will people think? What will they do if we witness to the gospel? The Holy Spirit has been given to us as the gifts, and the gifts of the Spirit as well. If all of us as Catholic Christians would allow the Holy Spirit to lead us, to take away our fear, and give us the courage to witness to our faith, where could we be as we move forward in the future? Wouldn't it be wonderful if we could double the body of Christ, the church? And sometimes we think, well, what can I do? I'm just one person. Well, it took those few men to do it. What makes us any different? They were like us. They were afraid, lacked courage, but the Spirit moved them and united them and made them the church that we are today. And so as we celebrate this great feast of Pentecost and remember that great event, I'd like to suggest, don't think of it as a past event, that something that happened 2,000 years ago. It continually happens. The Spirit continually breathes upon us, gives us the gifts we need. All we have to do is say yes and not be afraid.
Thank you.
Father has gathered his church in unity with Christ. With joy in our hearts, let us ask him.
Send your Holy Spirit into the church.
You desire the unity of all Christians through one baptism in the Spirit. Make all who believe one in heart and soul.
Send your Holy Spirit into the church.
Lord God, Father of us all, you desire to gather together your scattered children in unity and faith. Enlighten the world by the grace of the Holy Spirit.
Send your Holy Spirit into the church.
Through the Spirit you make all things new. Heal the sick, comfort the distressed, give salvation to all.
Send your Holy Spirit into the church.
Through the Spirit, you raised your Son from the dead. Raise up the bodies of the dead into everlasting life.
Send your Holy Spirit into the church.
Let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Let us pray. God our Father, let the Spirit you sent on the church to begin the teaching of the gospel continue to work in the world through the hearts of all who believe. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Before the blessing and dismissal, I would just like to thank Dr. Rossi and our Scola for their great work. Thank you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.